Alright everyone, this is Zero Budget Geek, and welcome back to Tales of Berseria. Alright guys, we are picking up where we left off last time, and something that I didn't realize I had to do, and I shouldn't have to do, but it turns out that I was complaining about some frame rate dips that you probably didn't notice because they were very minor, but they were there. I was noticing it. You know, I have some stuff to notify me, and turns out that there was a mod that was created to help fix that, and hopefully that will fix it up. Although I think I'm still seeing some frame rate dips. Anyway. We're gonna just continue the game because I don't think they've been that bad.
What joy to face a clear, refreshing morning. Especially after a long night of meting punishment on my heartless betrayer.
My poor, battered body.
You better not kill our key.
You're one to talk. Better not eat the boy. He's your precious key now.
I know.
Oh? You're facing the Shepherd and an Empyrean. Old Shepsy's one thing, but Empyreans are, you know, just gods who created the world. You think you can win just by smacking it around a bit?
That's no Empyrean. It's a phony. Artorias is just using a legend to control the people. Wouldn't a true god be able to do something about the demon blight?
You don't believe in Inominat?
I believe there exists something people call Inominat. But it's just a Moloch that used a special art to bring the other Molochim into our world.
You sound confident.
I witnessed it 3 years ago.
Well, if it's not actually a god we're against, we just might stand a chance.
Of course we do. And ultimately, our target is Artorias. I don't care about anything else.
Revenge against Artorias. For her brother.
All right, Lafayette. Which way is the Empyrean's throne?
It was north of Logris, in the mountains up the Danann Highway.
If exorcists are keeping up their inspections, they might provide us a chance to steal another Moloch.
I sent my men a Sylphjay with orders to scout out the inspectors. With their information, we'll be able to plan the attack.
We can meet up at Port Zexen.
That's the plan.
Okay. Secrets of the Sylphjays. Well, let's find out about that.
Those Sylphjays are handy little birds, aren't they?
Not only will they always find their destination, they can make for emergency rations in a pinch. I hear grilled Sylphjay goes rather well with a nice glass of the hard stuff.
It's because of the work those birds do for us that we're able to stay one step ahead of the Abbey. Those birds are indispensable to us pirates, and we consider them a part of our crew. Don't even joke about eating them.
All right. Still, I wonder how they actually do their thing. I know that carrier pigeons rely on their homing instincts, but Sylphjays can locate a person wherever they are, right?
They're really smart birds. I read in a book that rather than memorizing locations, they can pick up on people's wavelengths. When you send out a Sylphjay, the bird can sense the change in your thoughts. And we'll seek out the recipient you have in mind.
I hardly ever see them in the wild. Are they a kind of Moloch or something?
No, they're not Molochim. They're just an incredibly rare species native to an island in the north. It's a funny story. A chance storm sent us docking at that island, and a mother Sylphjay got blown onto our ship, eggs, nest, and all. Sadly, the mother bird died almost immediately. But Benwick stepped in and kept her eggs safe and warm.
So that's why they're so attached to him. Usually, they're really hard to train as messenger birds, too.
That's Benwick for you. He's always had a knack for things that would give other people trouble.
Maybe when they hatched, they took one look at his wild hair and mistook him for their mother.
You know what? They are comfortable enough with him to use his head for their nest. So you might have a point. Now that you mention it, he did ask me not to hit him on the head, because one of the Sylphjays just laid her eggs.
Well, if more birds are on the way, we could just eat one to see how it tastes.
No! Don't even think about it!
It was worth a try.
I don't know if he's serious or not, or if he's just messing around. Moloch ranks. Alright.
to meet you all. Just so you know, I'm a greater Moloch. You're a greater Moloch too, Luffyset. I'm sure we'll get along great.
I'm classified as a greater Moloch?
That should be no surprise. You've got a lot of power, despite your appearance. You're a greater Moloch too, aren't you, Aizen?
So I've been told, but I can't say I care for measures made by folks who tether my kind.
I didn't know that's what it was.
I'm sorry.
No, don't worry about it. Just promise me you won't judge your own value from a label given to you by others.
I won't. I promise.
What if that's all that gives me self-worth?
They're pirates and demons. Pay them no heed. To me, you are the greatest of all.
The greatest? Do you really mean it? Oh, Miss Mogulu, you're so kind! You've changed so much since I left.
But you haven't changed at all. You are eternally my greatest servant.
Oh, I don't want to be the greatest then! Oh, this is bad, bad!
And our roster of the oblivious grows longer.
Alright. Not sure how I feel about that being food, guys. Just kind of corny, but supposed to be some comedy relief. Now, one thing I do want to check out. Oh, we've got, we got some things to check out, actually. This guy.
Hey, I remember you. I'd never forget someone dressed as weird as you guys. You're those traveling misfits. The ones who did that dove act in Logris. Mad Lou's Menagerie, right?
It's Moggy Lou's Menagerie. Get it right or pay the price. So, you saw us in Logris?
That's right. I was there on Port Zexon business. I really looked forward to seeing you perform, but it never happened. But today's my lucky day. How about performing here in Port Zexon tomorrow? I want to see that sullen girl go coo again. It was hilarious. And that magician's dove trick, too.
Sure, but I'll have you know we don't come cheap.
Oh, I've got the money. I'd pay anything to see that again.
No.
Oh, come on, please?
Take a hint.
Hey now, don't be like that.
Sorry, friend. Best give it up. Otherwise, my apprentice here might show you a special trick she's been itching to practice. One where she makes you disappear.
Ooh, that sounds fun. Do it!
If you insist. But just a warning, there's no guarantee you'll make it back. Still want to try?
Wait, seriously?
Seriously. And remember, it's Moggy Lou's Menagerie. See you at our next show.
Magalu's always ready to take advantage of an opportunity. Now, I'm curious if we can go back down. We can. And I kind of want to do that because we have... Isn't there supposed to be a demon? Code red demon. Couldn't remember what they were called. Also, I didn't get to check this part out before. Oh, I forgot to go to the store and sell all that stuff. Damn it. We need to do that. Well, grabbing these is worthwhile. And we need to find out if we can find a code red demon down here. Now, I don't know if we need to flip those switches again. Hopefully not. Now, going this way leads to that. Do we need to do that? One thing we didn't do is we never went down this corridor here. So, if I remember correctly, it leads to a dead end. Screw you. Oh, shit. Appeared right in front of me. Alright.
Now, rise, arise.
Oh shit.
Ascending angel!
Bam!
You really do have a peculiar air about you.
Yeah, I don't think you're one to talk.
Alright. 5 to... what is that? Just stats. Alright, whatever. Stuff we've seen before. So hey, we can go down here. Might as well. Well, grab this. Grab those. And let's head down. And see if we can find... there's supposed to be a cold red demon down here. Alright, well, there's a plant down here. This is worthwhile. Go ahead and eat it. Oh, shit. Oh, for a moment, I thought Magilu was not. Oh, we can't have everybody in at once, though. We can only have 4 active. That's why we need to be able to switch out and stuff. Okay, well. Interesting. Alright, let's see if we can get past these guys. I want to find the cold red demon, and all the other times the cold red demon, we could just see him, so it wasn't like super hidden. So let's see what we can find out. I don't know if we're supposed to wait until we get like an alert that there's a cold red demon here. Excuse me. We'll try this. We'll explore, and if we don't find it, then we don't find it. Alright, this part here should be pretty straightforward. I gotta be sure to not click the button too fast when we... this is a life bottle, right? Oh, apple gel. We'll take that. Ignore you. Broken artifacts. Oh, we also wanna upgrade our equipment, don't we? That's something I want to do. I try to do that off camera, though. Alright, we can go down, but I'm going to check the back here. Oh, no. No, spirit orb stings. Alright. Did we ever go this way and down? Wait a minute. Where does this lead? I think we checked this before. Did we not? And yet, it led to a dead end here. Or maybe not. No, I think we did this. That's where the life bottle was. Alright. Hunt for the cold red demon. More tarnished coins. We gotta sell those. And excuse me, and I'm pretty sure we went down here already. Yep, we got that. And then where was it that we came through? We came from here, right? Yeah, we came from there, so that's not the way to go. City drainage system. Now, I don't remember if we went down and explored these parts. No, we did. I remember this. But we'll grab this. We'll grab these here. Hope you don't mind me exploring a bit. But hopefully we'll get a big payoff and find the cold red demon. Or else I'll be kind of stumped as to why we couldn't find it. Expedition has returned. Let's go ahead and deal with that real quick. Alright, they didn't do too well. Send them to this place.
Scout ship setting.
Yep, fine. Moving up. We did go down, we went down that end already, because that's why the leaf is showing there. Oh, well, hey, I'll take these. Nothing like extra spirit orbs. I'm sure there's something I'm missing. No, ignore you. So where does this lead to? Did we ever go through here? Yeah, we did. We went through there. That's how we got further in our story, right? So then I didn't. I never checked, I think. Ooh, you almost got me there, you bastard. Almost got me. So I don't think we went down through here. We might have, but I don't remember it. I don't recall it. Oh, we did. We did do this. We did do this. All right. So then maybe all of this is a waste. Cuz we are in the area that we're supposed to be, according to the information that we got. Let's see what happens when we go through here. No, it just leads over here to the exit. So no code red demon, huh? Oh, there's still more to explore. I think in here was where we ended up finding that dire foe. That was fun. But it wasn't a cold red demon, though. It was probably much stronger. Alright, well, we can use that to warp to get out, and we can't go through here. Well, that sucks. I wonder what's happening at the palace. Alright. Well, shoot. Alright, well, we... Oh, they said more stuff. Alright, well, at least we know we made a full-fledged effort. So we can now leave and go on our main quest. Man, I really wanted to find it. Alright, where do we go? Through here, and then down over here we go to the right. Alright. Oh wait, there's somebody over here we want to talk to. Where is he? Where are you? It's probably nothing, but...
I hear the High Priest was injured, and will be recuperating somewhere for the near future. The church is saying he was cleaning his villa when something fell off a shelf and hit him. But there's also rumors that thieves snuck into the palace and attacked him. If that's true, who could have done it? He's always been there for the people, and everyone looks up to him.
What a terrible rumor.
Indeed. I want to believe it's just that, a rumor. But it's got the children all frightened.
I'm not scared at all! Liar! Sis saw you crying! I'm the one who's not scared at all! If any bad guys show up, I'll handle them!
Ooh, scary. I'm sure bad guys won't come near you.
Something fell off a shelf? Nice. They're doing a really good job of covering this up.
If it got out that the High Priest was murdered, and in the castle of all places, the people would lose faith in the government.
Alright. Yeah, he is dead. I mean, how are they gonna cover that up? He's dead. He was eaten by his own, creature that he had there. Oh, we need to clear this stuff up. We are right next to a shop here, though. So let's go ahead and do that right quick. Boop, boop, boop. Sell. And we want to sell stuff that's... Where is it? What's this? Balmy fluid. Where the hell is it? Alright, tarnished silver coins. We'll sell all of those. Oh, they sell for 20 each. That's it? Alright, there we go. Boom. Alright. I'll do the enhancing and all that some other time. Alright, let's get out of here. Let's get a move on. We want to progress the story. Even though I kind of want to take my time with this game and just kind of enjoy it. Because there is a lot of content to this game. So we're going to be with this game for quite a long time. I'm expecting I may be somewhere in the vicinity of maybe doing like 100 episodes on this game, possibly. Before we leave, I see there are some folks to talk to.
Man, I've been feeling really out of it recently. I was much happier when I was drinking sweet, sweet nectar. It suddenly got a lot harder to get. The price shot up 20 times in the black market. I came to the capital hoping it'd be easier to find, but no one's got any.
Give it up. It's got vermilion ore in it.
What? Vermilion ore? I heard that stuff is crazy addictive. Real bad news.
It'll be easier to quit now that it's harder to find. Real sailors don't need that crap, right?
Yeah, you're right. I don't need nectar. From now on, I'm going to the bar after work. Hey, buddy. Thanks for the tip.
Okay. Alright. So yeah, in lieu of talking to every single citizen, we'll do like these exclamation point ones. Because they sound like they're kind of important. Not super important, but they are interesting.
Lord Arturius' speech really struck a chord with me. I'm sure everyone else in town feels the same way. Actually, it would be problematic if they don't.
Why would you have a problem with that?
One word, lady. Business. The ceremony to move the great Empyrean Inomata is going on now, right? After a speech as moving as that, anyone would want to offer a prayer to the new Empyrean. Which is why I'm selling commemorative chalices. They've just come in from Port Zexon.
Oh, Inomata's blessings are many indeed. Are you decorating the chalices with anything?
I'm just about to deliver them to the craftsmen to get them engraved.
I just hope all this effort doesn't go to waste.
Impossible! This is the perfect opportunity. I guess amateurs just don't get it.
I may not know business, but I know how this story ends.
Artorias, the ceremony, all of it. I'll end this by my own hand.
All right. Well, not super sure that was worth delving into, but the fact that they've bothered to have a voice actor perform that makes me want to, you know, seek those out and try them out. All right, let's do a regular save as someone was speaking.
Meet up with the scouts at Port Zexon.
All right. Port Zexon is our destination, which, if I'm not mistaken, is through there and just a straight shot. All right. Leave me alone. Alright, we'll fight you because...
Killing flash! But on this wolf, I won't miss! Form zero! Thunder!
Well, that about does it.
Alright. Reminding us about Switch Blast again. We haven't been doing them. I'm not...
What's the matter, Lafayette? You look like you're not feeling well.
Doesn't he always?
You can stay out of this.
You're a demon swordsman. Aizen is a cursed Moloch. Mogilu is a bizarre witch. But... what am I?
Turning existential here.
You're Velvet's tool and emergency rations, aren't you?
That's what Lady Teresa called me, too. A tool. But... I'm alive.
I get it. You're starting to wonder what your place in the world is. In that case, there's only one answer. You have to decide it.
Huh?
It's all up to you. It depends on what you want.
That's what it means to be alive. You control the rudder of your life. Your hands on the wheel.
My life. My rudder.
Doubts are okay, too. They're just further proof you're alive.
I'll protect you until you find your answer. Your arts have helped me often enough.
All right. I don't really understand.
but thank you. Pretty, pretty words and all. But take care who you listen to, kid. Demons and reapers, remember?
I hear there's a wicked witch about, too.
Touché.
Get going or get left behind.
We risk the wrath of the revenging reprobate! For now, let our rudders take us forward!
Magilu is... She's annoying, but she's also funny, too. Like, I enjoy her bits. As crazy as they may be. And I want to grab all these spirit orbs whenever we can. I think we can skip these fights. These are all... They should be much lower level than us. Although I think if we're super high level, if we're much higher level than them, I think they either run away or don't appear. What was that? Oh, okay. I know there's in the other games there was something about if you're much higher level, you either don't have to fight things, or even if you get into a fight with them, I think you automatically win, or something of that sort. Alright. I think here all that we're doing is just going to the dude. Oh, we never opened this? Or is it just a reset? Well, that's interesting. And I want to talk to this guy here about the cold red demons, because I really am kind of perplexed. Yeah, you. Alright. The harbor town smells of sea, tra-la-la, check and request. Okay, here you are. Corrupted orb, territory, Barona Catacomb City Drainage System. We were there. Right? Barona Catacombs. And let's check the world map, just to be sure that Rona Catacomb City Drainage System. We were there, we checked the whole thing, we didn't see anything. So, maybe it just means that they're not 100% always there. And you gotta come back every once in a while. Possibly. Alright. Let's push on here. Hello? Speak! Oh my freaking god. Hello?
Did the Sylph-J reach your men?
Yeah, they're scouting the checkpoints.
They're not back yet?
No, but they won't be long.
Let's rest for a bit. I'm hungry.
Yeah, me too.
We'll rest until the scouts are back then.
Okay. Are they back? Somebody wants to talk to us. The scouts were sent... We sent... are doing their very... We know... They know what they're doing. Security must be really tight if it's giving them a hard time. Alright. Although somebody up here wants to say something. Who is it? Where the hell is he? Was it down there? Oh, he's on the ship. That's Rangetsu.
No way. You managed to get some? Shh, idiot. Not so loud. Behold, the finest drink there is. Ilyanya Red. If Benwick and the others find out we have it, they'll drink the whole thing.
Wait, you didn't tell them about it?
Of course not. Those guys couldn't care less what they stuffed down their gullets, as long as it gets the job done. The subtle notes of this exquisite libation would be lost on those louts.
Well said. Now I believe some Rucarella cheese would complement this Ilyanya nicely. We'll have to hide the bottle until we can get our hands on some.
Heh, leave that to me.
Wow. Talk about oblivious.
Alright, so... Oh, we can talk to him from here? I just sharpened my blade. Mind if I test it on your tail? Of course I do. You're a monster to fight monsters with, I tell you. Alright. Anyway. There is something over here. But it... Alright. That way there's a star. So, let's pick this up and then we'll head into the... next screen. Oh, we're by ourselves. Alright, we're gonna end things here because we're near the end of the episode. We'll pick up right from here next time. So guys, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you soon.